Now, we all know training a puppy can be a bit of a nightmare, and my next guest, Michelle, thought when she was training her pooch, Clive, he was a bit boisterous. But it turns out what he was actually trying to do was save her life. And she joins me now alongside Gail Barrow from Medical Detection Dogs. So, Michelle, I've actually just seen what Clive does in action while that film was going out. He is literally saving your life every day. But just take us back to the beginning of when you first got Clive, because you were struggling with your health at the time, weren't you?
Yeah, that's right. When we first got Clive, I was fit and well. Nothing wrong with me. We got him as a pup, just as a companion, really, for a dog of mine. And then we got him in the March, and by the October, I was taken seriously poorly. I'd spent quite a while in hospital, got diagnosed with Addison's disease.
And what's that?
Basically, it's your adrenal glands that sit on top of your kidneys. Have self-destroyed. They don't produce a hormone called cortisol. And that hormone is fundamental to life. It regulates your heart rate, your blood pressure, keeps you alive, reacts to any stresses that you might have. It keeps you alive, basically. So, you know, unfortunately, my adrenal glands have destroyed, and I was on tablets at the time.
Yeah.
So I'd lost my confidence in things. I just stopped going out. My life was my four walls. And then my husband had said, we ought to go to Crufts. We love dogs. Why don't we go and have a look?
Yeah.
So the following March, Clive was a year old by this point.
And you'd found that he was constantly jumping up at you all the time.
Yeah, struggled.
And always, like, in your face.
Yeah, I struggled to bond with him because I just thought he was the most annoying dog. I kept pushing him away. And I think the last thing people want when you're not very well is a dog in the face.
Yeah.
And for me, I just kept pushing him away. He kept coming back. I kept pushing him away. He kept coming back. And obviously, unbeknown to me, he was actually trying to save my life. And
yeah.
I mean, I feel guilty now for that time, but I didn't know at the time. And yeah.
So tell us how you found out then. So you went to Crufts, didn't you?
Yeah, we went to Crufts. Just by chance, bumped into a stall. It was a Medical Detection Dog stall, so the charity. Picked up some leaflets, as you do. Got talking to a couple of people there. Went back to the hotel and read these leaflets, and I just thought, that's not possible. A dog cannot save my life. How can a dog help me continue with a normal life and save my life every day? It's just not possible. It's a dog.
Yeah.
So I was very much in that mindset. However, the next day we went back and got talking to the CEO of the charity, Dr. Claire Guest. And she'd said, well, how are you with dogs? And I said, well, actually, I'm not too bad, but I've got this most annoying dog at home. He's only 1 year old. He's clingy. He wakes me up during the night. I can't pinpoint when it is, but he's just so annoying. And obviously to her, it was ringing alarm bells. But to me, it was annoying. And she said, look, I want you to get in touch after Crufts is finished. And I want to have a look and we might be able to help you. And we got training with Medical Detection Dogs. We went through the application process, and 18 months later.
So what you've realised is, when Clive is jumping up at you, it's to tell you you need something, isn't it? So your dog was realising when you were in adrenal crisis, essentially.
Yes.
The dog knew to tell you, because it could obviously smell something on you, and then that would mean you would take the medicine you needed to take. So is this it now?
Yeah.
Right, so this is it happening in action. Well, that's timed, isn't it?
So now when he does this, so I'm connected to an adrenal pump, I will just pump some more steroids in.
Yeah.
And obviously because, like, today's a little bit unusual and we've been busy, he's obviously detected that my cortisol level's dipping a little bit below normal.
Yeah.
So he does his reward.
And this isn't planned. This is not a TV thing. This is a real life, because I saw this happen when you first came in. And every time it's to make sure you know to do that.
Yes, yeah.
That's incredible.
And each time he does that, we're potentially saving an ambulance being called out, a hospital stay. So actually, Clive's done that, like, I don't know how many hundreds of thousands of times. So you've potentially saved over the last 8 years hundreds of thousands of pounds for the NHS, because you're not needing an ambulance and you're not needing to go to hospital.
Yeah, it's incredible.
And now he's done his job, he's fine. He's seen me injecting.
Yeah. I mean, Gail, can you just explain how this works then? Because you work with helping to train dogs like Clive, don't you?
Yeah. Dogs have a fantastic sense of smell. That's the sort of cornerstone of what we do. The key is to make it as positive as possible for them, because it can be quite worrying if someone's unwell, yeah, experiencing episodes. But we just make it all a game for them. We have samples that we get from the clients, and we make the smell as positive as possible, using treats, toys, whatever, yeah, floats that dog's boat. Play games and get them used to the smell being around. And then hopefully when they go and live with their client, it just becomes normal to them to have a bit of a party when the client feels unwell.
It just sounds amazing. Like, can any dog be trained to do this, or is it a particular type?
Some dogs are better than others. And not all dogs actually use their nose as much as some. You know, some are very visual dogs. So our trainers do a fantastic job preparing the dogs for us, getting them to use their nose, playing games with food, toys, tennis balls, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
So it's not for every dog. And, you know, Clive was Michelle's pet dog. We actually provide dogs through the charity as well. But there are pet dogs out there that are doing the exact same thing for their owners.
Yeah. So how do you know that? Because there might be people watching who either want to get a dog that might help them,
yeah,
or have a dog and, yeah, are wondering, can it help me? What, yeah, would you say to them?
If you don't have a dog, I'd say approach the charity, look at the website, and everything will be explained on there. If you have a pet dog that seems extra clingy when you're feeling unwell, or possibly extra disobedient, you, yeah, know, that it can go one of two ways. They're trying to tell you something, they're picking up on the odours and trying to get that message across to you.
Yeah, so again, have a look at the site. That's amazing. Michelle, thank you so much. Clive, thank you very much as well. Gail, thank you too. Also, if you want any more information on all of that, we'll put it on our social media. Still to come, Pussycat Doll turned Ice Queen, Kimberly Wyatt will be here. Find out her gruelling rehearsal schedule right after the break.